Hey guys, welcome back to Phaser TV. I am Daniel DDK Kapadia, as you can see right there. And there you go. I didn't practice that, so I have to just look at the monitor. But we're having the knife round right now for map number two. It's going to be Nuke. HellRaisers didn't do so well there, being kind of saying that repeatedly. So I'm really curious to see what's going to happen now. Of course, you know, generally it's not their kind of best map anyway. So, all right, that's fair enough. But they are playing NIP, and NIP, top three team, top two team in the world, perhaps, with maybe Titan, you could say, or Fnatic. It's very hard, but those three teams definitely right up there at the moment for live events. And we're moving into the pistol round now. So how are HellRaisers going to do against NIP here? And NIP, they lost the first map, Dust 2, which was, of course, the pick of HellRaisers, and they lost that 16-9. So it wasn't even that close. Big, big, big first map from HellRaisers. So NIP with a lot to show now on their map. They need to reverse the dominance to make it look even more severe. Here they go. HellRaisers trying to raise hell indeed over at ramp, taking it over. And uppers, you know, the upper side is, you know, well and truly secure. So this always allows options. Giving up ramp is okay sometimes, as long as you play well on the upper side, because you can travel down very quickly using the vents and using secret and so on. So it is something that is very, very important to understand. And look at the patience coming in. Forrest with a double there and a triple. Get right going down, and here goes Forrest looking for the quad frag, and look at that, another headshot. Forrest is making the highlight reels with moves like that. So 1-0, they're going to win that pistol round. So now it's just the anti-eco situation that we all know and love. And HellRaisers, what are they going to decide to do with this? Are they just going to run like headless chickens into the ramp room or the upper side, or are they going to take it slower? Looks like they're actually taking outside, which is always quite interesting if you think about it, because, again, the pistols aren't so good long range. Rifles are pretty good long range, but here they go. They're actually making their way through main into the site. Exist, though, and get right, locking it down on the upper side. Angel winning himself a FAMAS, but it's not going to be much good. They only took down one player. Freiberg lost his weapon, but that's okay. Here they are just rebuying. And we have AKs all around right now for our terrorist side, HellRaisers. Not many nades, though. We can only see two grenades for them. Two flashbangs, to be precise. So that is a very low amount of grenades, so they got to use them well. And it looks like Angel's going to get himself up on the silo to begin with, see if he can get a pick. And Fifflerin, you know, he was actually doing really well here on the Group A play, which we saw a couple days ago on Wednesday from that position. He also, on the T side, was doing extremely well on the outside as well, you know, pushing, being the front man, pushing secret all the time. But here he has some backup from Forest. Looks like, you know, they're just going off of a small read to see if there's going to be any kind of aggression over from the radio room. But actually, there's not even a single player for the HellRaisers in the radio room, and they are making their way outside. Wow, look at that pickoff onto Get Right. Now, here you go. Forrest is going to float on back, and Fifflerin has to keep control of the ramp room to stop any flanking coming in towards the ladder. That is always very dangerous. And here is Freiberg. He's going to be shutting that door there. And they line up for him, but he can't find a single frag. The FAMAS not good enough, it seems, as Kucha makes his way outside. So Exist and Fifflerin still alive. It's a 2-on-5. They're pretty low, though. This is actually kind of doable if they execute well. And look at that. Two frags coming in from Exist. So it is actually a 1-on-3. But look at the health here. 19 for Kucha, 10 for Angel, 43 for Adren. Exist, if he does this well, it could all work out for him. Look at this. And there it is. Takes down Angel. Oh, but he's looking away now. He's going to catch Adren, looking for the fifth one, but he won't find it. Kucha will shoot him in the back. And that was actually quite well played by HellRaisers. I mean, it took three men, basically, to actually take down Exist in the end, but the way that they did it was quite smart by kind of forcing him to look at it in another direction, because it could have quite easily been a situation where Kucha would re-peek after his teammate died at the top of ladder. And then, you know, that was a situation where Exist was still looking there. And then it's a 1-on-1, a 1-on-1, and then another 1-on-1. But instead, Exist managed to find himself in a much worse situation because of HellRaisers' team play. So definitely well played to them. So 2-1 is the scoreline, and we have a lot of ground gained outside from HellRaisers. They've taken over secret right now. They are moving down towards that lower bomb site. And ninjas in pajamas, they haven't actually decided to really put anyone in the yard, which is safe. They've given it up completely. They're okay with that. They didn't lose a single man yet. So they are aware of Hellraiser's options here. So they are going to prepare for it. Hellraisers, though, you know, having taken outside so easily and so quickly, they are just taking it slow, and they're boosting Kucha up here to heaven. Let's see what he can accomplish there. Forrest is waiting to try to stop them from moving towards that ladder, and they are just boosting even another player up there, Dozier, who's going to help boost Kucha up to heaven. And Forrest still waiting. Look at that. Moving out of position just at the wrong moment. He's going to get caught. Very poor timing for Forrest. Markloff going to attack through main now. And they are just methodically taking control of the upper bomb site, and it's only Get Right with the mag and Fifflerin remaining to try to do something here. Are they going to go for the save, or are they just going to go for the frags? Get Right's going to lose that mag, trying to do a jumping shot over there, but nothing going for him. Fifflerin just waiting over at the lobby side of Hut. There goes a flash. Looks like they know exactly where he is now. And Fifflerin, he's going to have a very hard time surviving here. Look at this, going for the knife. Oh, Angel's so cheeky. But there you go. NIP, you're going to lose that round. So 2-2. Hellraiser's tying it up. And already they're showing a much better start than, you know, typically we saw them having yesterday. Yesterday, again, bringing it up, I mean, it was generally a snowball effect from the very beginning of the game. And already, you know, they're bouncing back from what looked like not the best start in the world. And now NIP are forced to a pistol. And look at this, they're just running all together through towards ramp. And they're actually going to boost up to Hut there. But they're going to be too slow. They've taken the frags at ramp. Here comes the flank. Kucha there with the spray on the AK to deal with Get Right. And there's nothing for NIP to do here. I mean, what can they hope to accomplish? Look at this, four players with rifles staring you down. You're not going to survive. Dozier tossing the flashbang down below. Fifflerin and Freiburg with a kind of a crossfire, kind of. Not exactly, but it will do. And let's see if they can get a frag here. It's very much a 50-50 for Fifflerin. But there it is. They come in from both sides at once. So well played. And look at that. There is actually a team frag. Kucha onto Markloff. Oh dear. Oh dear. That's a lot of money gone. But it's okay. They are still very flush. Their economy is starting to really, you know, boom. It's starting to get underway. They just need a couple more rounds to really, you know, secure and solidify a very, very strong money situation, which is going to allow them to bounce back very effectively if NIP manage to win a couple rounds later on. But at the moment, NIP have to worry about this round right now. We're starting off with a slower situation. Jumping into the overview, we can see Dozier, you know, just chilling outside, you know, waiting for the smokes to dissipate. He's actually going to get taken back down by Forrest, moving up to the dog walk. So good play from him. Now, Kucha, Dozier running straight on through, or Adren rather, into the upper bomb site. Oh, they're all kind of blocking each other over at the hut, but Angel's going to be able to execute there. Got more to do, but Fifflerin and Freiburg doing a great job to react very quickly. Very quick response. And it ties up the game 3-3. So that's quite important there, because NIP, you know, it's always harder to buy up as the CT side. And that makes your money situation much more fragile. And that's basically what Hellraisers were about to do. And again, if they manage to lose this round, they can get really screwed over on the money again. Get forced onto an eco. And that's exactly what they do not want. And there you go. Kucha going to get taken down by Forrest. Gotta love the little movement tricks there from Forrest. The timing worked out very well. That's something you can practice. Big, big part of the game is timing straight off the spawn. And Forrest knows it well. So it seems as if our Hellraisers are trying to gain some ground outside. They are actually taking down Freiburg. That opens up Secret. But Forrest in the dog walk again. He's looking for the shots here. This is such an important position. He's very exposed there. Look at this. He's just dead meat, Angel from below. As soon as they work out he's there, it's so easy to take him down. And now Get Right does respond well. So this really shuts down the big push from Hellraisers, but they do have two men remaining. Here goes Exist. Look at this. Oh, but Markloff on point. Him and Dozier now against Get Right and Fifflerin in a 2-on-2. And as we just check out Get Right's position, look, it's a really good position for him. he's not really going to find himself in any trouble anytime soon as he holds that spot. Fifler and just making sure that the ramp area is secure. And look at this, Dozier and Markloff going to make their way through now. And Getrise position too strong. There he is. He's going to get traded with Markloff. So 1-on-1 now. 4 health left on Markloff. Goes down to Fifflerin. Very well played there. And always very tough to come through main. There's so many angles to look at. You've got to look at, you know, up and behind you, up and in front, to the left, to the right. There's so many spots where the CTs can be. So, but they, I guess they really felt the time kind of beating away at them there to try to make a move. So it's a good attempt, but not quite good enough. And we have a 4-3 situation now, thanks to Fifflerin and Getright. So they go, taking up the usual spots. And again, we have some interesting action going on outside as well, as Freiburg takes down Markloff, being a bit cute over by the hut. And my god, CZ75, that gun is pretty good. But Freiburg is better. So here we go, the eco's over for HellRaisers. They're going to be able to buy up again. Here come AKs. AKs all around. It's happy hour. So we haven't seen much testing of the ramp just yet. We've seen some one play or so on upper, some solid players on the outside, and that really seems to be outside. Really seems to be the comfort zone of HellRaisers, and wouldn't be surprised to see more and more of it. But teams tend to not do the upper rush too often, as it can be quite easy to defend if you know it's coming, or if you know a team likes to do it. It's very good as the kind of one-off strategy, but actually look at that Angel. He made the stepping sound, let Getright know where it's coming from, Getright ready for that. And now they're slowing it down. They've got a minute and 10 seconds to work with, so that's totally fine. Look at this, Forrest has the garage under control. Dozier trying to kind of wrap himself around the back, around to CT spawn there, but Forrest is preventing that. Again, limiting what HellRaisers can do in this round. Edren, though, that's really important. Picked off Fifflerin. And we can see that most of the NIP players are concentrated in and around the kind of upper bomb site and the lower bomb site, that kind of area. And they're not really on the outskirts now. So there's a lot of potential for HellRaisers to make something happen. And look at that position from Edren. Totally unexpected for Forrest. Caught him completely off guard, moving it to a 3-on-3 now. Great play from Edren. Got to hand it to him now as Freiburg plays it coolly from the catwalk. Looks like they're trying to make their way lower, but they still haven't committed. But there's 15 seconds left now. How are they going to do this? Right, just intoxic there, waiting for someone to try to plant. And this is surely it. Now there goes the bomb down. That's got to be the end of the round. There's only 5 seconds left, so NIP going to secure this one. And a much longer round. I think you can attribute it to the fact that the early kills kind of threw off what HellRaisers wanted to try to accomplish. And that's really the difficult thing. If you lose a man early on in a strategy, sometimes you have to just change it up. You have to stop and be like, okay, we gotta hold back. We've got to figure out something else now, because what we originally were going for is just not going to work. You can't lose people too early sometimes in some strategies. And Forrest, here he is, took down Dozier last round. He was trying to get cocky, trying to take over garage when Forrest was there, and here he is again now with the AWP instead. And look at that. Oh, Edren with the AK headshot onto Forrest. That is a big frag in the yard there. And look at this, they are reacting as if it was just that, moving quickly now onto secret. Lovely little flash from Exist there. And he might just find himself a frag. It's just spraying down Angel. Doesn't quite find the kill, though, and he's getting pretty low himself. He's got to back away and try something else out, because peeking again is just going to result in the death here. 6-3 is the score. And HellRaisers are looking great in this round. And there's 50 seconds left, so they don't have to feel too pressured by the clock just yet. Edren taking the duel with Fifther and unable to take him down quickly. That is very, very sad for him. Fifflerin causing a massive delay right now, even getting the frag. Big play from Fifflerin to stay alive there. And now we can see HellRaisers, they aren't entirely sure how to go about this. They're trying to work their way back around to the upper side. They've got a player in main taking down Freiburg. Now Dozier's going to chime in on the upper side. Great team play there The team play 1-2 coming in to take the upper bomb site. But look at this. The bomb is just sitting there by Secret. And Fiffler is defending it still. There is 9 seconds left. There is no time at all. Fiffler can just even leave the bomb there. They have no time. There's no way they can do this. And my goodness. That was so interesting because they had the fast pickoff on DeForest. They managed to push the yard, gain a lot of ground there. And the problem, they had a few problems along the way. First of all, it was Fiffleren, because Fiffleren kind of put the stop on the movement on Secret. And then they were kind of left in a situation where they didn't know exactly how to proceed. They managed to scrap together a good upper push afterwards, but then the bomb was just left outside. That upper push could have worked, but that bomb was just, that was the problem there. And again, so, and the only reason that happened is because they had to scrap together a play out of nothing. And they didn't account for where the bomb was. Unfortunately, time can be a real pain in this game for the T side. But it makes it exciting as well. So NIP, you know, showing their strength, going up 7-3. And they've been going up 7-3 in really hard rounds. HellRaisers has been pushing them to the limits so far. And get right, it's not going to see a single thing. Smoke carpeting the yard there, allowing HellRaisers safe passage down to Secret, down to the lower bomb site. And again, Adren, so good up on the silo. Wouldn't surprise me if he practices that every day, just for 30 minutes, just shooting from that silo. And look at this again, 35 seconds left now. They need to make a move somewhere. Freiburg locking down the vents. So things are getting more and more difficult now, with just two players left against the four of NIP. Markloff does find himself down on the lower site, though. Oh, and he does. He's able to call the position now, and Dozy is, he's aware. He's going to make the frag as well. No armor on Dozier, though. That is painful. And here goes Fiffleren. Very fast response. If Markloff dies, it's over. And there it is. The bomb is dropped. And that's going to be the round there. Dozier falls as well. So HellRaisers struggling. Big, big struggle against the Ninjas, as is expected. And of course, you know, it is a CT-sided map. As you know, every commentator will remind you, is Nuke. A decent enough result you could, you know, expect is, you know, you'd be happy with 5-6 rounds on the T side. 7 rounds feels great. Anything more than that, it just feels amazing. Anything less than 5 starts to feel terrible. And right now, HellRaisers are in that spot. As the Ninjas approach the 10 rounds that they can feel super comfortable with moving into their T side. So here we have Dozier once again, looking at every single angle outside, trying to win options, and they just love this outside. There's Forrest, beautiful headshot. I love how Forrest is mixing up his play on the outside here. And again, he's got support from Get Right. Look at that jump across it. Oh, beautiful. Adren makes the jump, and that actually gives him the kill onto Forrest. Kucha is going to fall, though. It's Adren and Markloff left for HellRaisers as Fiffleren guards the top of ladder with his life. Look at this, Adren. Oh, look at this. So well played from Adren. Crouching all the way to the side so that Fiffleren cannot see him. So well played. Freiburg exist and Get Right left. As you can see, Freiburg is covering main and the vents. So NIP have a great setup going here. Now they know. Now they see it. Markloff going to get killed over at the lower bomb site, dropping that bomb, and Freiburg rather finishes it off. So pretty controlled here, and HellRaisers persist with a lot of these outside plays. We haven't really seen them make some kind of big movement onto the ramp, and we haven't seen like what I was talking about before, where it can be nice, you know, maybe one or kind of two rounds to put together a really strong, very, very fast, well-executed upper rush. That can work in a 3-hut, 2-door, the kind of standard sort of thing. Can work if you catch your opponents off guard. Doesn't work if it's ever expected. And 9-3 now the score. As we see again, outside, outside, outside. But Get Right, so prepared for that. Freiburg's guarding Secret. Dozier's going to have to back away by himself right now. All of a sudden, just their plays just combusting in front of their eyes. Just, it's not looking good for HellRaisers with these outside plays at the moment. And it's not even that they're able to accomplish nothing. We've seen a lot of great entry kills. You know, that Adren working that silo very well. Sometimes, you know, outplaying the AWPers and so on. They do get some frags outside, but they just can't quite seem to pull it together after that. The next step doesn't quite seem to pull in line for them. There we go. Fiverrin does actually get flashed over at ramp, but it's nothing other than just, you know, a flash to annoy him. As we can see, they have a good spread though. They have a player in radio now. One in lobby, three outside. Again, the split that HellRaisers love to make. And Kucha with a very crucial frag onto Get Right outside. As Angel is going to pre-flash main, make sure that it's safe to proceed. And now they got control of the outside. So this is already looking a lot better for them. They didn't lose a single player yet. And with the strength of the AWP there. Oh no, Exist going to come in and take down Adren over at Hut. So Adren, it's not so great to lose him there. If they were planning on making a play on upper, Adren is a really big playmaker in that sense. But now they're going to be considering something else, I think. As Freiburg is kind of locking down the kind of ladder room position. They cannot go up to heaven there. Look at this. There's just nothing to do. They're kind of stopped there. There's not much more they can do from that position. And slowly they are faltering. Exist going to take down Dozier as well. So it feels like their plan didn't really... After they lost the man in Hut, it feels like they kind of didn't know how to proceed. They got stopped completely over at the ladder room. And it felt like they didn't know where to go after that. So definitely NIP just completely deconstructing HellRaisers' strategies and plans so far. And making an 11-3 scoreline at this point. 12-3 is going to be very, very nasty if we see that. We do have a buy. Here goes the upper strategy that I was waiting for. The Molotov is there, but look at this. It's so hard to deal with. Even with the smoke, they are going to put it to a 3v3. They should get the bomb down, but they're actually backing away. Maybe trying to catch a rotating player, but didn't feel like, I guess, they had the time to make the plant. I'm not sure, but they are switching things up here. Despite clearing out the upper site, they are deciding to use the time in the round that they have. And look at this. Get Right. Oh, he had a little bit of time to make the flick shot, but does miss it. Love how Dozy was jumping above the box there just to have, you know, a little bit of sight to see where a player was. You can see it worked very well for him. But now it's a 3-on-2 after they lost Get Right. He was looking precariously previously into the upper site. But right now we have 40 seconds left on the clock. Fiffleren now, he's very aware that there had to be someone else there, and he gets the bomb down. So it should be very simple now. Dozier making this move through, and he's going to get dropped by Forrest. So HellRaisers, it feels like they start the rounds well. Many rounds they started well, but then it tends to fizzle out after a while. They don't seem to pull together somehow after that. I don't know what it was, whether it was just NIP kind of threw them off with how they were playing it, because NIP were giving up yards quite easily sometimes, and HellRaisers, regardless, they weren't able to capitalize on the opportunities that they gave themselves, and now they're looking at a very, very hard scoreline to deal with. 12-3, not great. They lose the pistol round. They're done, basically. They are done. So let's see if they're going to be able to do it. We have an outside push here coming in from NIP. Adren and Markloff able to take down Freiburg and Forrest, so they're starting it out well, and Adren drops the bomb. Crucial information there for his team, HellRaisers. Dozier are going to take down Get Right as well. Exist now, the last man standing. Let's check him out as he tries to clutch away in a 1v4 situation. He's got the Glock in his hands, and Kucha will silence him with the USPS. So, okay, we're back in business. HellRaisers is going to grab the pistol round for the second half of this best of three. Of course, if you're joining us, just joining us, NIP versus HellRaisers. HellRaisers, of course, ex-Astana Dragons, finally rebranding themselves. And this is the GSL eGaming Cup playoffs with $2,000 in the prize purse, $1,300 of which goes to the first place team. 500 for second, and third is 200. So really fierce competition for first right here, that is for sure. But right now, this is for the tie game. NIP need to win this map to tie things up and force it to the third map, which will be Inferno. And so far, Forrest is unleashing an inferno onto Angel with that deagle, and he's ready to drop very soon now. I think his work is done in the outside, but there is actually another player rotating around, and there he is, Dozier. Is Forrest going to find this headshot? My God. I don't even want to, if I was in Dozier's position, I don't even want to risk it, but he's going to go for the tap action on the FAMAS, and that is enough, it seems, as it looks like this anti-eco's going quite well, and I like how NIP are thinking about this round. You can see the deagle, as it was improved, it still does quite a fair amount of damage if you hit a body shot. And of course, the headshot's always going to be an insta-kill, so it's nice to take that weapon outside. And we're seeing a shift as well. It used to be that we saw a lot of SMGs for the anti-ecos, but as these stronger pistols came into play and the SMGs don't perform so well at ranges. In fact, the pistols can often outperform them at ranges. These teams are basically going towards the FAMASes and the rifles, the major rifles, to actually deal with the anti-eco situation. So, and NIP were kind of displaying why that was. I mean, that with those deagles, they make a headshot on you long range, you're kind of done. And with an SMG at that range, you're kind of screwed. So, HellRaisers now 5 rounds to the 12 of NIP. As we move into this one, we are seeing, what are we seeing? We're seeing, all right, looks like an upper movement coming in from NIP. How are they going to do this? Here they are, jumping through the door, and Adren just mowing them down. NIP wanted to get that one over with quickly. That much is clear. So 12-6 now on the score. HellRaisers in a very hellish position. I mean, if they managed to take this back, they just win. They won Dust 2. 16-9 on Dust 2. Again, if you missed it, it was pretty dominant. HellRaisers actually, maybe it's the rebranding, the new name. I don't know what it was, but they were just performing excellently. Here we go. They're making the push on outside. Adren, tapping for those heads through the smoke. You can get lucky with that, so liking it. And here we go. NIP are moving their way down through Secret onto the lower bomb site, and just They've moved down so quickly that they have a lot of time, so they can take this slow. There is no rush. And you can see Forrest is just very responsibly guarding the back of his team. Markloff will fall as they flood on into the bombsite, and Freiburg plants in amongst the smoke. Exist, gonna spot himself Angel. This round is looking very strong for NIP, and Fifflerin coming in as well. Fifflerin performing very well today so far, and it's just continuing as he's looking for the last kill, but he runs out of bullets, unfortunate. But there's nothing that Dozier can do to offset this victory. Absolutely nothing. 13-6 now. NIP climbing ever closer to that victory they need to bring about the third map, which will be Inferno, the tiebreaker. Do love an Inferno myself. So here we go, again, AWP on Markloff. Let's have a look and see what Markloff. So okay, Markloff's gonna go to the outside position here. Let's see if he's gonna catch anything. There go the smokes. This is why AWPing can be very difficult outside, but here he is, T-Red, Fifflerin gets dropped. Oh my God, Markloff! Forrest flies through the air. Markloff picks him out of the sky like a clay pigeon. And right now, that is gonna tie the round together, wrap it up in a nice bow. Poor HellRaisers, lovely stuff from Markloff. That is why he gets the AWP. That is the sole reason. And Exist wants to save the round. But Markloff has been very dangerous so far. And there it is. There is the third frag coming in from Markloff. Angel emerges from Secret to take down Getright. But Getright has other things on his mind. Markloff looking for the next shot. There it is. Oh my God, Markloff. I think that was a four-man right there. Beautiful stuff from Markloff. That is definitely going to be one for the highlight reels as well. So 13-7 now. I mean, if Markloff keeps doing stuff like that, I would be pretty worried. NIP are 6 rounds ahead, but I would still be pretty worried. So Markloff, danger outside. Do NIP feel like they can challenge him? Right now, they're not running with many weapons. They got a CZ-75, 3 rifles. This really kind of shows that they are going to do something fast here. So there are the smokes, though, to prolong and delay NIP from making a move. But look at this, Fifloon trying to get some info there. He was one of the pistolers. He had the CZ-75, and he was there to gain information, not really do much more. But here they go, flooding on into the ramp room, overwhelming Markolov, only getting one frag before he dies. His team has to react fast. The response has to be quick and clean. And here they are charging through. It is slowing down a little bit as Freiburg tries to make the frag there, but Dozier's position. This is predictable, but still dangerous nonetheless. And Dozier trying to edge out onto the angle, and they are just holding now. NIP slow down the aggression. But here they go. They flip the switch, the aggression turned on as Freiburg sprays for his life as well as exist, and they do take down two players. It's becoming a 2-on-2 situation. It has become a 2-on-2 situation with Angel looking for his frags. Angel, the last man standing now, and Freiburg with a massive round. And NIP are now 14-7. And despite Hellraiser's beautiful stuff on the outside, NIP put the test on ramp, and we all saw what happened. Even though Markolov actually rotated towards ramp, but the problem was for him was, I believe, his position. I mean, his position was just kind of bad in the end because he got a shot off and he got a frag, but he didn't have time to escape, and that's really the problem there. And I think it's because he rotated and they switched him from outside to ramp. And Markolov coming in again. Here he goes. Beautiful stuff with a scout headshot. There it is, the jumping shot, but Freiburg was waiting for exactly that with a great response. And Fifloon is waiting now for some sneaky guy to come up secret. But this is looking like an open and closed book affair right now for NIP as they have managed to assassinate all the players, Hellraisers, in the previous rounds, looking to do so again now. Dozier and Angel running with those pistols. Kucha's got the CZ-75, so where is he actually? Let's check him out. He's over by the vents and waiting for someone to walk through the hut, but it's not going to happen just yet. Looks like Markolov and Angel get a bit of a... Oh, Markolov gets an assist onto Angel's frag there. So 3 versus 3. And Getright, oh my god, Getright putting the spray in there, takes the entire clip to kill Kucha. And there's the last one found as well. So it was scary for a moment, but NIP brought it back in the end. 15-7 now, as we are almost over with map 2, it seems. It feels like. And NIP are set to show that they can be even more dominant on their map, because of course we saw 16-9 for Hellraisers on Dust 2 against NIP, and I am happy with this result. I'm very much looking forward to seeing Inferno between these two teams, especially. Here they go. Forest is just charging on through the smoke outside, just double checking that no sneaky CT player managed to sneak behind the main there. Looks like they're taking things slower now. They're taking things much slower. We have Fifloon outside. He's got some help there as well. And Forrest is with him, takes down his player on secret. Fifloon wins his duel outside as well. Here comes Kucha. He's going to take down Freiburg, but can he get the second? He does. So they equalize 3 versus 3 now. Kucha with a third frag. The triple is huge right now. Adren cannot survive. Fifloon does make his way through with Forrest. Very, very strong little team of players right now. And those two, Dozier there over at door. He's got to get out of this position. It's not a good position. He's got the Famous in his hand. Oh, wow, he does take down Fifloon, and his Forest dies as well. What an interesting round there. That was all about Fifloon and Forest on the outside. But Hellraisers, they managed to come together in the end. Really, really big play from Kucha there on the hut. That completely saved it there from Hellraisers, who managed to lose both players outside to separate duels. That is always a very, very horrible situation to get into. But we're seeing from Forrest, it looks like he wants to boost up onto that silo. And look at this, Markolov going for the jewels outside with the rifle. And they're all around him. And there goes Forrest up on there as well. Here he goes, jumping on down. Will he find some frags with the Deagle? Fifloon's trying for it. Oh, and he gets a Dren. Long range headshot with a Deagle. Markolov spraying down the pistol players from NIP. So 2 versus 3 now. And actually, a lot of damage done with this Deagle. You got to be afraid of that thing. It can be an instant death. You just don't know what's going to happen when someone has a Deagle in their hand. And it's Freiburg's Deagle as well. Here we go. Looking for the next shots. And Get Right's last man standing. He's going to fall too. So 15 to 9. And HellRaisers, they might lose, but they're going to make NIP work for this. So as we can see, Freiburg and Forest topping this, their respective scoreboard. Different in the middle there. And I have to say, you know, since I last saw NIP playing, seeing much more. I don't know if Piffer has just improved or what, or you know, his kind of positions have changed, but seeing a lot more from him lately. Here we go, Markloff moving around the corner. He sees the end of the gun. Oh my god, that is horrible. Forget right, he goes down to that. And Adren, oh, look at that precision onto Fifflerin. Fifflerin, usually the man to poke outside. And he's going to feel worse for it now. Looks like they are trying to move through ramp here. Here goes Freiburg. Can he make the entry kill? He is blind as a bat. Exist, though, has his back. And he's going to make his way in. He's against four players now. Exist needs to make the ace. He's going to win this round. And Dozier catches him in the back of the head with the M4. So 15 to 10 now, and it's just one more round, NIP. It's just one more round. And that's how it must have felt for so long now. As the HellRaisers show their character, their attitude, their spirit. The spirit that you need to be a champion. Never give up, never surrender. No matter how bad it looks. And that's what we're seeing from HellRaisers so far. And I'm so happy they finally managed to, you know, get themselves under a different name than Ixastana, which was, quite frankly, a little bit annoying sometimes to have to say that, because I would always want to just say Astana. But here we have a lot of players in the radio room. Looks like NIP want to test the defense on ramp. Dozier put to the test, and he is found wanting right now, only getting one frag with the spray. Has to pull out the pistol, and thank God he has support from Angel right there, because it wasn't a very good spray at the beginning, and he doesn't even die. So there you go, 15 to 11. And we're going to see the buy now from NIP. They've all got AKs. They've all got the double flash smoke HE combo. They all got the helmets. It's looking like a very strong buy for them. So I wonder how they're going to do this here. They have the ability to play it really slow. But we haven't seen any super fast rounds from NIP. We've seen, I think, maybe one or two, but it's mostly on the ecos. They have a lot of men outside here, though. So we could very well see a very fast round outside. Here go the nades. Trying to cover the yard with those smokes. And they've done it. They've created a path with smokes to provide coverage. And look at this. Get Right doing what he does best in those one-on-ones, like on the outskirts. And Dozier, does he dare move through the smoke? He knows Get Right's lurking. And look at this. Angel going to try to take the shots. Angel in the very tough spot. Very good smoke grenade from Angel. That is so, so crucial. It's going to be so hard for them to move through that smoke onto Angel's position. That is a massive delay coming in from Angel. And look at this, they know they can't do it. They have to back away, and they're just taking their time here. But Get Right has managed to find his way around to ramp now. So Get Right can make it happen, and he's going to take down Angel, and that's a really crucial frag. They can actually push through Secret now if they want to. Forrest is going to do just that to regroup with his teammates. And this was all made possible by Get Right's finesse on the flank through ramp. Dozier now working alone. This is going to be very tough for him. And this could be it, unless Dozier comes out huge in this round. This could be it for HellRaisers. And NIP could force it to the third map, Inferno, in this semi-final on the playoffs. Here we go, Dozier. Not much to do. He's going to go down to Forest. And there you go. Map number two, won by NIP, 16 to 11. So a much closer match, you would say, than the first map we saw, Dust 2, where it's kind of a steamroll affair from HellRaisers. They played very well. So we move on to Inferno now. Remember, this is the GSL Egamingbets Cup, and $2,000 is comprising of the prize purse. And they're fighting for a big chunk of that. And we're going to go to a quick break, guys. We'll come back very soon with map number three between these two awesome teams.